All right, so it's 4:07. How many of you are actually interested in organizations? Oh, wow, that's a large group of people. Hello, everyone. My name is Ayan. I'm the co-founder and CEO of Ampersand. We are a new startup, which is helping SaaS businesses and ideas. When Arjun was inviting me to the talk, you know, we had this consideration whether we need 45 minutes or 20 minutes, and I was like, okay, maybe we just need 2 minutes, because this is the slide that I want your input on, and please send this to your HD, right, with Ampersand.com. I'm kidding here, really. The real talk happens now. These are the number of marketing tech companies right now in the world. And this is just companies that are not doing any marketing. I know you guys are taking pictures. It's supposed to be so small, so that, you know, all the actual companies are on those pixels. This came out of Scott Baker's chief market, and there is an equivalent sales tech and customer success tech and RevOps tech market map. And this market is also growing. It's not like static. It's growing year over year. And the fact that we are all here is a testament of that. I'll briefly introduce myself, but before that, the key question is, should we bother that this is growing at this pace? Is this something to be bothered about? I think yes, because I think all the marketing effort that goes in down the funnel, as it goes bottom of the funnel, you're not talking about your customer is asking, hey, do you connect to Grace? Hey, do you connect to Iterable? Hey, can you do that deep custom object in Pardot? And then you're like, okay, sure, you know, you can do it. And then your edge team is like, I don't know why we promised that. Because this is not going to take 6 hours, it's going to take 6 months, right? So this is a very common problem that we've seen in SaaS business in general. I introduce myself, my name is Ayan again. I'm the co-founder and CEO of Ampersand. We do deep product integrations with your customer CRM and go-to-market stack. We're backed by Matrix and a bunch of other good funds and agents. I was the VP of Eng at G2 from 2018 to 2022. I have seen a little bit of Indian data moving around. We were shipping a lot of Indian data into customer CRM. Before that, I started a company called Symmetry back in the day, which ended up creating this category which I'll talk about. G2 acquired us in 2018, and then I started running the engineering there. We actually created the spend management category between 2016 and 2018. The story that I have for you is that we created the category but we didn't build, which is an interesting journey that I went through as an entrepreneur. There's a bunch of billion-dollar companies in that space right now, including Ramp. One of the reasons why we didn't build it when we look back is the fact that there were multiple reasons for it. We didn't really have a coherent integration strategy, and a lot of time was wasted just doing DIY integrations. So that kind of problem really burnt us throughout the course of Symmetry as well as G2. At G2, I know we're still trying to figure out our simple integration. And it's already like 100 plus ARR, 100 plus ARR. So that's our background. What I would do differently is the highlight of the talk, given that I've gone through this journey multiple times. The core hypothesis I have is that your SaaS is likely an AI system of action. Most companies that are starting today are not starting as a system of record. It's likely a system of action, whether you have agents on them or you don't. Likely going to be a system of action. What is really important is that your product should natively speak with your customer's system of record. And this is now becoming extremely table stakes. Your customer comes in and they want to connect their marketing stack, they want to connect their sales stack into your product nearly. When I say system of record, what does that mean, really? So there are, I'm thinking through, like the audience here is large marketing, I'm thinking through what are the systems of record that really matter to your audience. And I could find 6 or 7. So first one is CRM, all the data is there. The next one is marketing automation platforms. Some of the marketing automation platforms are really well connected to the CRM, but some of them are not. So in that case, you may have to build a direct marketing automation platform as well. The next one is CDP, Segment, and a bunch of other partners. So that's the third category of system of record. CMS, so there's a bunch of like Adobe Experience Manager type integration that you can build because your customers' assets are getting there. The next one is really digital asset management. It's kind of similar to CMS, but it's a category of its own, so you may have to build connectivity there. The data warehouse has also come in very strongly in the last 6-7 years. So a lot of your customer data is likely in the data warehouse. So you may have to pick up data from your customers. So many data bricks. We are helping a bunch of companies pick up data from data bricks daily. And then a lot of this customer data that is moving around isn't actually log and fireflies. A bunch of these call recording software and it's kind of unstructured as well as structured. So we have to deal with that. So what are some of the problems that we face during our journey? As I said, some of this data is extremely structured and some of this data isn't. So your product and engine teams are likely grappling with this reality that if I pick data up from my customer Salesforce, it's almost like a database, very relational, very structured. But if I'm taking data from Gong, it's actually just a stream, right? So how do I model this reality? So what we have seen good customers do is that they invest in a very flexible data model from the start. Again, this is getting, I'm starting to get technical, but if you have a flexible data model, then you can extend it as you please, as and when you have more enterprise customers. So that's first. The second problem that we see on a daily basis, as we already understand, is that your CRMs and your maps of your customer has probably been customized today. This is entirely, this is especially true if your customer is a big company. Imagine you're trying to sell to GE, and GE has 170 instances of Salesforce across 170 tens in many countries. So you have to understand how to reverse engineer that configuration. This becomes extremely valuable as you go up market. So the way to do all this is like understanding your customer's configuration or tenant, and then reverse engineering how they have configured and customized their CRMs, maps, DWs, whatever tool they live in. And doing this early so that your implementation time is going down from months to basically weeks. This is a big problem in enterprise now. I was at Dreamforce speaking on another panel. We spoke with a lot of buyers, and this is from the first time in the last maybe 10 years where the enterprise wants to move quicker because there's some pressure from them on them to basically prove ROI. So a lot of like this AI world is forcing them to buy a little faster. So velocity to ROI in this agentic world is extremely important. And how do you kind of onboard and implement? Can you cut down? If you're like implementing over 9 months. Your enterprise customer who was expecting 9 months of implementation time is no longer as patient, so your bill could be low in your enterprise. So that's something to consider. And the way to think about this is essentially, can you actually get the customer to configure their product, their integration in your product? If that's a strategy that you can adopt from earlier on, then over the course of time, your integration and your implementation journey is kind of very shortened. We have this problem at G2 all the time, and at one point we were like, okay, let's just throw more bodies at it. Let's just throw more solution engineering at this, sales engineering at this, but it can be productized, and that has a real impact on your ARR as well as your NRR. Lastly, I think that your enterprise customer will require a lot of custom integrations. You're likely going to see random CRMs, old marketing automation platforms, some asset managers that probably are custom built for a vertical or a geography. So you'll encounter a bunch of them. But the interesting part is, this is where a lot of money is. So we actually said no to everything that was custom, and I think that was a tactical as well as strategic mistake from our side. We left a lot of other people. I think we should just, as founders and early startup people, we should just follow the money. The last bit is essentially your enterprise customer doesn't want integrations to break. All of this data that they are bringing in into your product, and then you are likely shipping some of your analytics into their system. That entire syncing is infrastructure work and often breaks, resulting in a strange situation where your customer is like, hey, I'm getting all of this data, but it's kind of not really syncing likely in the correct manner. So maybe your product doesn't work, maybe it works, I'm not sure. So that had a lot of impact for us in our conversations. So the recommendation here is invest in integration of usability from the get-go. So those are five things I wanted to highlight. I was almost thinking of getting into code, but I'll avoid that and leave it for another session. Again, send this to your agent team, and we may be able to accelerate your own market.